Well,
relentlessly.
it's what they said, where we're, you know, we're getting to this point of what's next. You do get so dulled when you can see anything on the internet of the shock value, just what you were saying, how the Donkey Kong, whatever, 7 years ago was, you know, enough to get a show off the air, and now, you know, probably like a 16-year-old would do it on a YouTube channel and get a million hits.
It would
And
go
so you're
viral
right.
as the Donkey Kong Challenge, right?
The
And it,
Donkey
right?
Kong
it'd just be
Challenge.
repeated again and again by
For
everyone to be.
autism. Yeah.
For autism.
Some tag
Right.
at the end.
Yeah.
They don't even get it.
This is
They don't
actually
get
a program to identify the autistic people drinking cum.
it. Right. We're very literal.
Yeah, we're
It, yeah, it's
awareness.
amazing. I'm sure it's only going to, as we look back in 40 years, I think that to figure out what will entertain us, what will surprise us or shock us. I mean, you know, the idea that you can watch videos of people's lives ending and on the internet, and to think, and it is like those beheading videos, those ISIS beheading videos. If you've ever made the mistake of watching one of those are things that are so haunting. And yet probably kids, you know, I'm sure, like, we used to watch Faces of Death, if you remember that movie, where
Oh, yeah.
99% of it was fake, but they had one that was like a train crash killing a family or something. And
Yeah.
it was, I remember those things would like scar me. They would scar me. And now you can look up anything on the internet,
I remember when
which,
bum fights was really edgy. Like we would go and rent bum fights and watch the bums fight. And then of course there was an offshoot of that called the Bum Hunter, which was this guy who would dress up like Steve Irwin, do his best Australian accent, and literally stalk homeless people in back
Oh my
alleys.
God.
He's got a camera crew with him with lights. It's the dead of night. He's like, all right, there's a big buck over here. Yes. All right. Everyone stay down, stay down. He could get violent. And he literally attacks a homeless man. And the guy's like, what are you doing to me? He's like, hold on there, big fella. It's all right. We're not gonna hurt you. And he zip ties the guy up, like duct tapes his hands behind his
Oh
back.
my
He's like,
God,
all right. And the
committing a
guy's
felony
struggling.
on camera.
Yes, total felony on camera. And the guy's like, what are you doing to me? Why? Who are you people? He's like, hold on there, big fella. This one's getting rowdy. And he's like on the guy's back, and he's like, gets out a
Oh.
tape measure. Gonna take a few measurements here. He measures the guy's forehead circumference. He's like, oh, 16 inches. All right, all right. Yeah, just gonna mark you here now. Calm down, calm down. And the guy's struggling. He writes like a number on the guy's face with a Sharpie
Oh my
marker.
God.
And
Wow.
there's another guy over there with a clipboard. He's like, take this down, take. And he's like taking down the measurements, just like, you know, someone would do that for Steve Irwin when he had a big crock. They're like, all right, 17 feet long.
Oh my God.
And then at the end, he's like, all right, I'm gonna turn you loose now. It's all right. Go back into the wild.
It's horrible, it's wrong, and it's hilarious. And it's hard to admit. Like, you watch it and you're entertained by it. It's
And then you
I
think
sometimes
about
do
it for a
feel
couple
guilty.
seconds, and you're kind of just
Yeah.
like borderline kidnapping, likely a
Yeah.
combat veteran.
This poor mentally ill combat person who now is going to have nightmares. Like, someone zip tied me. He's like, sure they did. Sure, we're aliens, right?
Ever believe him? That's the
Right.
thing. He's gonna go the next day and try to tell this tale,
Well,
and they'll be
and
like,
that you're
the crocodile hunter
right.
kidnapped you last night.
And
You know
you
Steve
know
Irwin
how it
died years
is.
ago? How dare you disrespect his memory? But then
You
one guy
go
will like look over
online.
him and see the number and be like, yeah, 16. He got me last week.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you're number 31,
You
so he's
know how it
amping
isn't.
it up.
It's amazing how you go online to watch like an Aladdin video or something, and you end up watching the Bum Hunter or behead. Like, it just the YouTube sinkhole that just the this downward spiral you go on when you're just clicking videos late at night. It's amazing how inevitably it'll lead to porn, one of the two,
And
yeah, or
like
both.
the GIFs of death you'll see like on somewhere like Reddit, where it'll be like,
Oh.
that's not the name of the forum, GIFs of death or anything, but you'll see like,
People
you know,
dying.
some guy gets, you know, falls off
Yeah.
a bridge and you see him land, and it's just a GIF of that. And like you'll scroll between, like, for me, like a hockey score, a guy dying, and then like a cat trying
Right.
to catch a bird, and you don't even slow down anymore. You're just like,
Right.
that wasn't even a good one. He died for nothing. And he's like, he's
Yeah.
getting, like, keep going down. And you
Oh,
think about it for a
God.
second, you're like, God, if I would have seen that when I was like 10, like that would have been pretty, you know,
That would have ruined
pretty
my day.
numbing.
We need
No
to
wonder
address
Right.
that YouTube
Well,
murderer chick.
you wonder, like, the fact that children do have this access to anything, and that no matter how good a parent you are, the fact is, if they have internet, you know, they can see these things. They're growing up differently, for better or worse. I don't know. I don't know what the impact will be, but
probably for worse. Yeah, for
probably.
Worse.
Right? You know, they can't
be. They're like the children in The Walking Dead. They're growing up very different than their forefathers
well,
did.
I will tell you, for me, I know I spend way too much time on my phone, like social media, how you become a slave to it. And I know, like at night, like when I put it down and I can feel, I physically like feel my eyes scrolling. I can feel like that urge to check it. And I'm like, this is so unhealthy for me. And to imagine while your brain is still forming, to have this constant stimuli, like where you don't have to go out and entertain yourself. You just have it in the palm of your hand constantly. This thing that can entertain you to no end, rather than having to go out and be creative. I look at how it's a tool, you know, it's how you use it. And if you have discipline, I don't have discipline. So I'm on it way too much, but I do fear for our next generation. I mean, like if there ever were a power outage,
no, go ahead.
Well, no, I'm saying, like, just sitting here, like, struggling to have internet in a hotel, and I'm like, what the? What is this? How am I supposed to? Wait, I should be on Instagram right now. I can't go Insta Live. This is awful.
One of the worst things that happens to me, if I'm off it for a while, right? I'm not on Reddit or Facebook or what have you. It's like, 4 hours has gone by. I bet there's something new, you know?
Right.
I wonder what happened while I was gone.